I will ask you some questions. Is America a rich country? Yes, you brother. You say. Can you say? Is America a rich country? Yes, you say, bhai. Yes. Very good. America is a rich country. Rich. Is India a rich country? Mama, you say. Can you say? No. Okay. No. India is not a rich country. India is a poor country. Okay. Today we will discuss about a topic about the rich and the poor. The rich means the rich people. The poor means the poor people. Okay, children? So the topic is how poor we are. Look at this. Lesson 2, how poor we are. Now all of you take out your books and open it at page 32. Once upon a time, there was a very rich man. He along with his family lived in a big palatial building on the top of a hill. His house was surrounded by tall boundary walls like the Chinese Great Wall. The walls were his protection from outside attack. He too had private soldiers and a great bulldog to protect him. In moonlit nights, the building looked very beautiful. From there, one could see the river, small hills, long stretch of paddy fields, small huts of poor farmers scattered all around, all flooded by the magic of moonlight. During moonless dark night, the building had a special look of its own. The building, the walls all around, and the gardens inside were lit by lamps. From a distance, one could see dazzling stars in the sky, but the small huts were sleeping invisibly at night. The dazzling stars in the sky, the rich man lived there like a king, very happy. His happiness got doubled when he saw the poor farmers living in small huts down the hill, toiling hard in their fields. His only sorrow was that his only son did not like his richness and glamour. Often he found him sitting alone in his garden, looking down the hills at the poor farmers toiling in their fields and the rivers flowing by. He was found to be very indifferent to all the richness and glamour of his father. Okay? One day the rich man took his son to the poor people living in small huts down the hills. He had in his mind to show his son how rich he was in contrast to the farmers. He thought this would work like medicine for his son's sadness. When his son would see these poor people living in small huts, his sadness would disappear. He would realize how privileged he was in contrast to those poor farmers in a beautiful car. He took him all around and he said, he would realize how privileged he was in contrast to those poor farmers. In a beautiful car, he took him all around. He made him see the poor farmers living in wretched condition. For the first time, he saw who lived like a prisoner in a big house got the chance to see the outside world. Throughout the tour, his father was telling how these poor people were living in great difficulty. On his way back, very satisfied, he asked his son, "Did you see how poor the farmers are? What did you learn from this?" His son sadly replied, "We have one dog, they have four. We have one bull, but they have rivers. We have artificial lamps, but they have the moon and stars. We buy food, they grow there. We have walls to protect us, they have friends. We have encyclopedias, they have Bibles. Thank God for showing me how poor we are. Really, I want to live with them there." Now see, children surrounded by, means covered with all sides, surrounded. Surrounded means covered from all sides. Okay, children? The temple is surrounded by tall boundary walls. The Jagannath temple at Puri is surrounded by tall walls. Okay, so we have to use surrounded like this. Then bulldog. Bulldog means a big male dog. Okay, protection. P-R-O-T-E-C-T-I-O-N. P-R-O-T-E-C-T-I-O-N. Protection means give safety. Give safety. Protection. When our Prime Minister comes for his protection, several policemen are arranged in that place to protect him. Okay? Then Dazzling. D-A-Z-Z-L-I-N-G. Dazzling means twinkling, bright, brightness. Then invisible, I-N-V-I-S-I-B-L-E, invisible, cannot be seen, cannot be seen. Look at this, cannot be seen, which cannot be seen. Suppose it is a dark night, we cannot see anything. So that is invisible. The, everything is invisible in the dark night. Okay, invisible means not seen. Now, then toiling. T-O-I-L-I-N-G. T-O-I-L-I-N-G. Toiling means doing hard labor. Doing hard labor. The farmers, are toiling
field. Field.
In their field, the farmers are calling in their field. Okay, children. So in this way, we have to use them in the sentence. Then in the parent. Indifferent means dislike, dislike, like dislike. That means we do not want that thing. We dislike it. We do not like it. Okay. Then privilege means facilities. Then rights, WRITCHEB. WRETCHED, red. WRETCHED. WRETCHED, red means bad. Red condition means bad condition. The poor people live in a wretched condition. That means they live in a very bad condition. Okay, children? Then, another thing is that the difficult word is artificial. A-R-T-I-F-I-C-I. Artificial means man-made, which is made by man. Okay, then the lamps, the fans are artificial because these things are made by man. But the sun, the moon, the stars are God-made. They are called natural. Artificial, its opposite is natural. Okay, then we have given a very new word, that is encyclopedia. E-N-C-Y-C-L-O-P-E-D-I-A-S. Encyclopedias. Encyclopedias means K-N-O-W. L-E-D-G-E, knowledge, knowledge, books. The educated people have a lot of encyclopedias. That means they have a lot of knowledge books. Okay, children? Then, now I will tell you the story. Once upon a time, there was a big palatial. Palatial, P-A-L-A-T-I-A-L. Palatial means palace like. Palace like. Big palatial building. Okay, once upon a time, there was a rich man who lived in a big building. It looked like a palace on the top of a hill. Where was the house? The house was on the top of a hill. And it was very beautiful. In that big house, the rich man lived there with his family. Next, his house was surrounded by tall boundary walls. He had some private soldiers and a bulldog to protect his family. From his house, one could see the rivers, the hills, the paddy fields, and the small huts of the poor farmers. Okay, children? And when the farmers were doing hard labor in the field, the rich man was very happy to see that thing. because he was not a good man. He enjoyed the pain of the poor farmers who worked in the paddy field in bright sunlight. But on the other hand, his soul did not like his father's richness and wealth. Okay? His soul was quite different from his father. His father liked his richness and wealth, but on the other hand, his soul did not like his father's richness and wealth. Okay? When it is the moonlight night, when there is moon in the sky, the rich man's building looked very beautiful. It also looked very beautiful in moonless night or moonless dark night because the rich man decorated his house with little lights. But on the other hand, the poor farmers have no electricity facilities. So they had no artificial bulbs or electricity bulbs to switch on. When they were going to sleep, they put out their kerosene lamps and slept. So in that area, one could not see in the dark night. It was invisible because there was no light at that time. Okay. One day, the rich man took his son to the area where the poor farmers lived. He wanted to show how rich he was in contrast. Contrast means comparison. In contrast to the poor farmers. So he took his son in a beautiful car and visited him to the area where the poor farmers lived in very bad condition. The son was quite different. He liked the farmers and he wanted to live with them in that home. But his father thought, when would the son see the bad condition of the poor farmers? It would change his mind and like his richness and glamour. Glamour means G-L-A-M-O-U-R. G-L-A-M-O-U-R. Glamour means beauty. B-E-A-U-T-Y. Beauty. Glamour means beauty. So this is the gist. Now children, I will ask you some questions and answers from this lesson. Okay children, where did the rich man live and how? Brother, you say? Yes? Can you say? No? Yes, I will say. The rich man lived in a big palatial building like a king. The rich man lived there very happily like a king. Now, where was the building? Or where was the rich man's building? Can anyone say? Yes? Okay, very nice. The rich man's building was on the top of a hill. What did the rich man have to protect him? What did the rich man have to protect him? What did the rich man have to protect him? The rich man had tall boundary walls, some private soldiers, and a big bulldog to protect him and his family. Okay, children. Then, How did the building look in a moonlit night? Can anyone say? No one? I will say. The building looked very beautiful in a moonlit night. Okay, children? Then, what were the poor farmers doing down the hill? What were the poor farmers doing down the hill? The poor farmers were doing hard labor in their field down the hill. Then, who do the poor farmers have to protect them? The poor farmers have friends to protect him. How did the song live in that big building? How did the song live in that big building? Can anyone say? Hello, brother. Can you say? No. Yes. Yes, mama. Can you say? No. The son lived like a prisoner in that big house. The rich man's son lived there like a prisoner in that big house. Okay, children, you can't say anything. Please, you have to read again and again to the topic. Okay, children, now I will ask you some short questions. Now see, choose the correct answer. Choose the correct answer. What is the question? The rich man lived in a... big building B, big palatial building, big palatial building, then small building, small building. Okay, children, what are the options? Look at this: big building, big palatial building, small building. See, small building. Can you say what is the correct answer? The rich man lived in a big palatial building. Okay, then the song was living like a deaf in that big house. Prisoner, king, farmer, beggar. What is the correct answer? Can anyone say? Can you say, mama? No. Like a prisoner. Okay. Then, the next time. Write the correct form of the verb. Write the correct form of the verb. Now see, he does do his homework now. We have to use the correct form of the verb. First
we have to know what is the tense of the given sentence. What is the tense? First subject, then we have given the verb. Now is used. When now is used, what we do at the time or at present? That is present continuous. The structure is the subject, then or is or are plus verb form plus other word. That is present continuous tense. So we have to bring its verb form, that is doing. And we have to take one of them. We cannot use F with he. We cannot use R with he. Only we can use he is then doing. He is doing his homework now.
Okay, children, we have to do like this. Then I will ask some sentences, whether they are correct or not, you have to see. Say true or false. The rich man along with his family lived in a big palatial building. Is it true or false? Is it true or false? Is it true? Then his only sorrow was that his only son liked his wealth. It is false. The son lived like a prisoner in that big building. It is also true. So children, we have to write the question and answers and read the lesson and question answers again and again. I will send you all the question and answers of this lesson and the sub-questions in your class. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.